Gregory Shelton with Historic Living Modern World. Today we're in Quarryville, Pennsylvania at Marina Bacher's home and private studio. She makes the most amazing soaps and candles that I've ever seen. She collects her ingredients from all over the world. We're gonna make some soap today with her, and I cannot wait to see her shop and see what she's up to. Let's go check it out.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Welcome to my house and my studio.
Thank you. Cannot wait to see it.
Welcome.
Marina, it's a pleasure to be in your private studio. And I have to say, your soaps, as I've always said, are the most beautiful soaps that I've ever seen. What makes your soaps different than everyone else's?
My soap is special and different. You're right. And it's even unique. I travel around the world. At this point, it's 70 countries. 2 weeks ago, I came back from Colombia, and I bring ingredients from each country I travel to, and with those ingredients, I make soap.
Wow. Can you tell me a little bit about some of the soaps that you believe are some from the rural countries that you find your interesting information from?
This one is, in my opinion, is the most unique. It has scent from Mongolia Gobi Desert.
Wow.
I brought it when I was in Mongolia 2 years ago. This one is unique. It has pistachio from Turkey, and it has bracelet, which I got in Colombia. Ladies from YU tribe made those, handmade.
Wow.
It's unique. Every bracelet is unique. You don't have another such bracelet
wow,
in the world.
Wow, it smells unbelievable. And I love the fact that, you know, people are getting a little interesting, like little tchotchkes with the soap that they buy to remember the soap, right? That's kind of what the brand is about.
This soap is unique because of its way how I made it. I took soap making class from one lady. She lives in France, and this is French souffle.
Wow.
It's made differently than this cold process soap. This is souffle, and it has some bubbles inside, and it's a floating on the top of water. It does not sink.
Interesting. Yes. So I'm assuming the souffle is whipped with air, right? So you're putting more air into it, right?
Yes, yeah. And decorated with flour, which I got from Turkey. Another nice bar of soap is this one. This has two kinds of salt. One salt is from Ukraine.
Okay.
And this crystal I picked up when I was in Colombia.
Beautiful. And what is this? Is this a salt smell?
It's...
Oh, it smells great. Wow. It has a little bit of a manly scent to it, a little bit.
Yes, and it has a charcoal. It's very good for your skin. Another soap which I like is made with poppy seeds, which I got in Croatia, and decorated with petals, which I got in Turkey. For last 2 years happened to be, I was in Turkey 4 times.
Wow. And do you normally, when you go on these trips, you're going to see other parts of the world. Is your mindset always thinking, what can I bring back for soaps?
Yes.
That's your main goal?
Yes, and I just see things which I can pick up. They are everywhere. It's from nature,
right?
Like sand, small stones. It's from city markets, like pistachio powder, some small rose petals. And just, I get some gifts from people. When they know that I make soap, they offer some ingredients, unique and unusual ingredients.
And you wouldn't get that if you weren't doing great things with what they give you, obviously, right?
And sometimes I just get coffee from duty free.
Okay,
yes.
Basic coffee.
Yep. Something I get for free from the nature, something I have to pay money.
Right. Well, I see the line, as an artist, you know, there's an art to what you're doing. It's not just, you know, to make these striations and this honey look and the, you know, honeycomb. You're an artist. So I think that that's another part that's it's not only with this different sense of smelling, but it's the look that really makes this beautiful.
When I make soap, it's like meditation. I never make soap when I have bad mood or I am unhappy about something. It's a creative process and I need to be in the best mood, in the best spirit to create nice, beautiful things.
Do you think soap making can even put you in a better mood if you possibly were in a better mood?
Yes, but sometimes I get bad mood if I if I spoiled a batch. That would be not the best. And also I have ingredients from around the world. I have several batches with local ingredients. This one has sheep milk from next door Amish farm.
Okay.
Yes.
So it's very local.
Yes, very local. Sometimes I make soap with honey, local honey.
Okay.
But this one honey is from Georgia, former Soviet Union.
Oh, sure.
I brought small jar of honey. My guide gave it to me for
that's
present.
Wonderful. How great
he
is that?
Just gave me present to make soap.
That's just unbelievable.
And this one, it has oak essence, which I made by myself. The house is in oak tree forest.
Okay.
Yes, I just pick up bark and make essence on this wood stove and use it. Yes, I like local ingredients and I like ingredients from around the world.
And do you, by any chance, do you find yourself ever sketching what the bar might look like, or do you just get in the mood when you look at your ingredients and just make it as it goes?
It goes.
Okay.
Like, unexpectedly, sometimes it's better, sometimes it's worse.
Sure, and then when I first saw your products, the thing that gravitated me as kind of an artist was a lot of people can go over the top with some of the tchotchkes and the way they put together. So wrappers and extra little line things. These are just, you're using what's in the bar and you're not decorating with something that's not in the actual essence of the oils of the soap, which I think is really great.
Thank you. I don't like paper. First of all, it increases price for my product and people put it in the trash. Let's save the planet.
I get it. That's a great way to look at it. And to me, you can have a picture of a flower or you can actually have a real dry flower. And I think that if that's in a bathtub, that's really beautiful. That's really what you're looking for.
And I would like always to add only one design. Usually I don't like several designs. It gets too much eclectic style. I like flowers on the top, but I am going away from that. I like the more simple, the better.
Okay. I think simplicity in design is very, very important. So Marina, your soaps are beautiful. They smell amazing and they are designed so unbelievably. I feel like there has to be something a little bit more educationally behind you that helps you make these so well. What is it?
You're right, Greg. I finished 5 years of university in Russia and my major was biology and chemistry. My first bar of soap I made 40 years ago when I was a student of first course, just first year of university. And I made just a simple one. It was oils and lye. It was sodium hydroxide. But after that, I did not do anything for 40 years.
Wow.
Maybe 35 years. And one day, I was walking in Madagascar, a very remote beach, and I saw a big, huge seashell. It was huge. And somehow, I picked it up, and I said to myself, it will be soap dish, which I will make. Soap I will make for my soap. And since then, I returned home. I started to do research for soap making, and here we are. And maybe I was making soap for several years, 4 years. I was just giving it for presents. But Corona time made a big difference for my business. I can say it went to business.
Well, that's great, and I'm sure a lot of people are excited that happened. And I think that's an attest that you've stuck with it, but you bring a scientific mindset to it. I think that it's a difference maker for them, a lot of soap makers. So we see you have beautiful soap. I love the story of where you come from to make them. Any chance we could learn how you make soaps today?
Oh yes, I can show you.
Let's do it.
Today we will make mint soap. And I will use mint from my garden. Let's go to cut it.
Cool. So we're in your beautiful garden. Here's your mint, right?
Yes.
So how much do we need?
We need only a little bit. I will blend it with water and I will use only a little bit juice of it.
Gotcha.
Yes. Let's cut this.
And I notice you're not using scissors because of the metal.
Yep. That would be the best to use just your hands. And it would be the freshest.
Oh God, it smells amazing. Wow.
Let's
That's
make
gonna make
soap.
Great soap. So you got a Vitamix here, right?
Yes. And a little bit San Pellegrino.
So Marina, I saw that you use Pellegrino. What's the basis of that?
I use San Pellegrino because it's a very clean liquid. It doesn't have any another ingredients like tap water has.
Okay.
Yeah. And when you use sodium hydroxide, it does not get another ingredients on the way when it's reaction going.
Gotcha. And I'm assuming that when you're pulsing the mint, that distributes the mint throughout the soap too.
Yes.
Which is very important, I would think.
I use only juice. I don't use hard pieces.
Okay.
I need 4 ounces.
Of liquid.
Yep. It will give a beautiful green color. And it also will give some ingredients, beautiful ingredients, which will be very nice moisturizing part in soap and nutrition part.
Okay, so we are making soap. Where are we right now?
Every bar of soap has 3 ingredients. Water, sodium hydroxide, and some oils. I make my soap with 7 different oils. It's a coconut, cocoa butter, olive oil, avocado oil, castor oil, sunflower oil, shea butter. I use approximately 55% of hard oils and 45% liquid oils. And here were hard oils, which I melted, and I add to here liquid oils.
Okay.
And after that, I will add lye to those. Do you see reaction is going on a little bit?
Yeah, it's starting to solidify a little bit, no?
Yep, reaction started to go.
Oh, power to it.
I will. And I see a little bit light trace. It's when oils and lye started to get into chemical reaction. And I add juices. Do you see how it's got thicker?
I can see it's really coming together as a total substance.
Okay, right now I can.
So these are standard molds, right?
Yes, and I put it in molds. Till I need to be fast, otherwise it will be thickened. Greg, I will add to decorate those batches with some ingredients. This ingredient is from Georgia. Former Soviet Union.
And what is that again? What is
it's a marigold.
Spice? Okay.
It's a marigold flowers.
Crushed marigold flowers.
Yep.
What do we have here?
This blue flowers from Turkey. I don't know name. Where I bought, people did not speak English, so just blue flowers.
But they dried very, yep. Beautiful dried color.
And they're very, very nice blue color. Yep, soap is ready.
Wow.
It was sitting for 7 hours.
Okay.
And it's time to cut it.
Looks beautiful. Wow.
What I do like this. A silicone mold, okay. And okay, I got
look
it
how
out.
Beautiful that is. Wow. Oh, it smells so minty.
That is how soap is born. Every time when I cut next, I have to wipe my soap. This beautiful knife is from Japan.
Nice, we know a little bit about that.
And Greg, I will give you to cut one.
Uh-oh.
You have to cut it one time. Here, I see. Perfect. Yep.
Oh gosh, you can smell how truly natural that is. I saw you pick the mint, but it really feels and smells exactly like your garden. The one thing I really look when I look at this is it's not your normal color scheme, which I think that's part of your skill set is you're picking colors that look different and they complement each other, but they're not perfect. I think that's really what makes this rustic and beautiful.
Thank you.
Oh, so beautiful. Marina, is there any type of ingredients that you haven't got yet that you'd love to get around the world?
You know, everything what I want to get, I get it because I travel every 2 months. But I would like to get more of this. It's a special bean which I picked up in Peruvian jungle, Amazon jungle, and I need to go back there. I picked them up myself, bitten by mosquitoes, and they're amazing. They look beautiful.
They are beautiful, wow.
They look beautiful in soap.
Yeah, sure. They're very striking colors. Is this a dried bean or is it
yes.
Just, okay. So Marina, I love your soaps. They're beautiful. How do I get them if I want to buy them?
You just go on Instagram
okay. And
write me in direct, exotic travel soap, and I will answer you and we will figure out what kind of aromas you would like.
So go to Instagram at exotic travel soap
exactly.
And message you that
yes.
They're interested in your products.
Yes.
Well, that's great to know.
Thank you.
If you like what you've seen today, click like and subscribe, and make sure you follow us on Facebook and Instagram. This is Gregory Shelton with Historic Living, Modern World, reminding you, whenever you do something, always work to move people. Cheers.